I'd like to call this July 13th, 2023 Board of Education Work Session to order. Nick, can you take the roll?
Mrs. Bissell?
Here.
Mrs. Kilbane?
Here.
Mr. Miko?
Here.
Mrs. Hausum?
Here.
And Ms. Stovcek?
Here. We could all rise for the Pledge of Allegiance.
To the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Next on our agenda is our district goals. District goals are financial prudence, academic achievement and growth, and community engagement. As a board, we strive to measure all of our decisions off of all three of these goals. As you can see, our table is a little light tonight. Mrs. Pelko, Mr. Riba, and Mr. Aganastu are on vacation. We have Nick Mancini, our assistant treasurer, sitting in for George. So we are going to wing it tonight and get through our meeting. So next we have Strongsville Middle School Track and Field State Meet Qualifiers. I'm going to ask Mrs. Blackman to come to the podium.
All right, I am here on behalf of the middle school track team. Mr. Demerly unfortunately could not make it, but I just want to give congratulations to the girls 4x2 team and the boys 4x1 team for their hard work throughout the season. This middle school state track meet is an elite meet. You actually have to qualify for it now. Before, anybody that wanted to go could go, but you actually have to qualify with a it's called fat timing, so it's a fully automatic timing system meet, and both the girls and the boys were ranked 20th to go. You have to be ranked 24th in order to qualify. If you're 25th, you don't get to go. So it's within the state of Ohio. You have to log on to BOMS page, and you get to see all of the times. So they did qualify a little bit earlier in the season, so it was fun. After every weekend invitational, we would look to make sure that they were still qualified. So with that being said, I want to give a big shout out to Chris Koval at the high school, Denny Ziegler, and Jason Kepler, because they're the ones that find the meets. And since the middle school state track meet is more people and more teams want to get to it, a lot of these invitationals can only hold 10, 12, 14 teams. Coach Koval up at the high school uses his ways to get us into more of these, and we were able to get into more of these so both of these teams could qualify and have this experience. So first I want to recognize the girls 4x2 team, so if you guys want to come on up. We do have one not here today, but Marlena, Lila, Reagan, were the girls 4x2 team. They had a time of 1:48. So that made them place 5th in the state meet. They were ranked 20th. The last time I ever went to a middle school meet was with Jackson Griffin and Kennedy Griffin, and you guys probably know the names. So they were had a lot of... It was a little bit different. They were able to just have fun down there, where I think Kennedy and Jackson had a lot more pressure that they felt that they had to be the best because they were ranked so high. But when these girls were ready to go, they were ranked 20th. They were in the second heat, and I was telling them, make sure you do your best, because if you win your heat, then that has a possibility that you can race the first heat, which would get you on the podium. And they did more than just that. When they finished, you could see their time right at the finish line. And then we stayed at the finish line, and they saw that they beat a lot more teams in the first heat. So congratulations, girls. Three of the girls are actually seventh graders, so we will miss Marlena next year on the team, but we will have to find somebody else to replace you. And hopefully the other girls will be able to go back down to the state meet next year. So we have certificates for them, and the state gave us certificates, so I will give them to them. And something that we were just talking about at the end of the meet, the girls were like, this is really cool. I go, yeah, we should use our makerspace and get it engraved. And that's the last that I said of it. And then all of a sudden, Adam Johnson comes in my classroom and he's like, hey, I have this all ready to go. I'm ready to engrave it. I go, where did this even come from? And they all worked together to kind of put out what they wanted on the makerspace. And this is the boys' one. But we were able to get it engraved, and they were so nice looking that the one that they actually used in the state meet is going to go in our trophy case. And then I convinced Mr. Kepler and Mrs. Boytum to buy more batons, because I'm good at doing that now. And now they all have their own, made right from Makerspace, with their relay team, all the girls on it, their time, and that they were fifth in the state. So thanks to our technology department and Adam and Dean for making these. It was a trial and error kind of process. So here's your baton to keep. They were all organized until my children were like, what's in the box? And there went that. And then here is your certificates from the state, the actual state. And then Strongsville made you guys certificates. Congratulations, girls.
Mrs. Blackman, we'd love to have the girls come up and we could shake their hands.
Oh, go ahead. You can go up and shake the board members' hands. Show off your baton.
Not that fast.
Congratulations.
Congratulations. If you want to get a picture.
Did you guys tell Mrs. Housem your color you were wearing today?
Yes.
All right, boys, come on up. We also have one boy missing, Al. He's overseas right now. So. All right, so the same thing for the boys' team. They were ranked 20, do you guys remember? I think in the 20s. And they were adamant to be better than that. So when they got to the meet, Kendrick actually also competed in the 100-meter dash, and he took third place in that, so the open 100. The boys, when we went to go check the boys in, we have a fun little story. So throughout the season, we kept telling everybody you have to have matching shirts, matching shorts, and everything. With the wonderful Cleveland weather, a lot of the starters were very lenient. They could wear hoodies, they could wear the long sleeve shirts, and they were very lenient. But when they came to the state meet, Kendrick saw firsthand when he lined up for the 100-meter dash, the starter did not like that he had some white logo on his shorts. So he actually had to run to the bathroom and turn them inside out before he could compete. So he did just that, and then he still took third in the state meet. And then we get to the boys' 4x1 team. And they are a little bit of a mishmash. Some had their, now we don't really have jerseys, because when we merged, we had to get t-shirts, and then COVID hit, and then we never got them until I heard the good news that we are getting them. So thank you. So we had some sleeves cut off of our jerseys. We had some mismatched shorts and everything else. So when we checked them in, the starter goes, they can't have these cut-off shirts. And so the girls were standing right there with me, and they're like, well, you know. So these girls had their shirts that they bought, and they sprinted to the other side and went and got their shirts so the boys could cram them on their bodies.
Oh,
just so they could compete. And as they were like, this is too tight, this smells. And I was like, it's that or you don't get to run. I don't know what to tell you. The girls did make a comment, and this is, I think, a memory that's always going to stick with me. When the girls handed them off, they said, "We're going to hand this off, but you better take at least fifth place." And as I said before, they were ranked, I think they were in the third heat, so the slowest heat, actually. They ran first. They got first in their heat. The second heat went, and they beat every team in the second heat. And then the first heat, which was the fast heat, went, and they were able to, you know, only four other teams beat them, so they took fifth. So I think the girls passing off the jerseys, you know, the last words of wisdom to them were, make sure you take at least fifth, and then they did. They took fifth. Their exchanges, all the exchanges were incredible, and I think that's what makes a difference in a track meet for that because of all the elite competition. So congratulations, boys. And now I think the word got out, so I also want to thank you guys and the girls because I believe Mr. Kepler actually just sent me a picture of the new uniforms that we're getting for cross country that the board approved and we got, and we're going to use those for like our elite meet invitationals and stuff like that. So we won't have a jersey problem anymore. So just like for the girls, we also did get the boys' batons engraved so they can have a memory and a keepsake. There you go, Corbin. So the boys 4x team did finish with 46.10 seconds, and it was L, Kendrick Bodie, Nathan Rodak, and Corbin Williams. So congratulations, boys. And like I said, Al is out of town. He's overseas right now. So go ahead and.
Congratulations. Congratulations. Congratulations.
And then the last thing I do want to thank is all the assistant coaches. I think that is one thing that makes Strongsville's middle school track program pretty elite. We're able to have 8 track and field coaches. We had about 225 athletes this year. And we were able to have it be somewhat of a well-oiled machine. You would have never guessed that there was 225 athletes out there. The girls would be doing workouts with Coach Klutzer while the boys were at their specialties and doing handoff exchanges with Coach Mester. So we are very fortunate that we have that many coaches for that many athletes, and they can really specialize in each event, and we can give each kid the opportunity to get better. So Coach Mester worked with these kids in the relays, and when Coach Mester wasn't there or there was too many relays going on at once, I mean, Coach Steffen, Coach Maloney, Coach Hurdle, Masenchik, Mr. Klutzer, and Mr. Demerly would all step in and make sure that they were able to get their exchanges down. So that's all I have. Thank you. Oh, I did forget. I did forget something. Coach Kepler, he would always want pictures for his newsletters, and I was really bad at taking pictures at every meet, terrible. So every Sunday, he would always have to send out through final forms to the parents, anyone get pictures for his newsletter, because he would always send me a message. I was like, oops, forgot again. So I do have to get a shout out to Mr. Rodak back here. He was the photographer master at the state meet. He just pulled out his iPhone. He even got questioned by one of the big head honchos, and he's like, I got my camera right here, and he just pulled out his cell phone. Like, isn't that everybody's camera nowadays? So we did get a lot of great pictures of them on the podium that we were able to send, and that was in the newsletter because that they were able to take them. So thank you.
Thank you. Congratulations to our athletes. I know how exciting it can be to be at the state meet. I was fortunate to be able to go 1 year with one of my sons, and I expect to see you guys all back here as you go through your high school career and see you on that podium again. So congratulations. Next on the agenda, we have public comment. And if anyone would need to exit now would be a good time. I know it's a nice summer night out there, so thank you guys for coming. Ellie Havanek, if you'd like to come to the podium and state your name and your address, and you have approximately 3 minutes.
Hi, my name's Elle Havanek, 16040 Acacia, Strongsville. So I'm here to present my gold award. It's equivalent to the Boy Scout. Okay, it's equivalent to the Boy Scout Eagle Scout Award. So it's a project where I'm using all my skills that I learned from Girl Scouts to make my community a better place. 5% of Girl Scouts get this award, so it is it takes a lot of time and effort, and yeah. So my project is called ROAR, so Reach Out at Recess. I'm working on creating a more inclusive playground for all the kids. I think that recess is an exciting and also scary time. I think a lot of kids are either really excited to go play with their friends or either scared because they don't know how to introduce themselves or just a little shy. So hopefully I want to implement ways that kids can play with each other and hopefully include each other. So I've worked with Affordable Farmhouse. They're a business in Brunswick, and they make benches. So buddy benches, I worked with them. They are making 3 of the 5, and then the other 2, they're donated by donated by community members. So the buddy benches, hopefully a child would sit on it if they want someone to play with, and then another kid would invite them. I know that some of the schools have them. I just wanted to create more because why not. And then blacktop games. I wanted some more blacktop games and some maintenance to them because I saw around and some of them were like worn down and the paint wasn't really there and you couldn't really see them. So yeah, more blacktop games. Especially I saw at Sarar they had a map of the U.S. and I really liked that idea. So I talked to the maintenance department and they agreed that they would be willing to let me borrow the stencil so then I'd use that and introduce that to the other schools. And then going along with the blacktop games, I saw this idea of a conflict path or a peace path. So if there's a disagreement between the kids, there'd be prompts on the ground so the kids can read off the prompts and settle a disagreement between each other just by themselves. There wouldn't have to be adult intervention. This helps them with their communication and being independent with being independent, which I think is a good quality to have, especially for the fifth graders. They're going into middle school, they have less hands-on approach. So, and then outdoor, more materials or like equipment for the kids to play with, soccer balls, basketballs, things like that. And then for the indoor games, I want to replace and update like board games or just things like that, because I saw that, or at least at my old school, they were like really run down and just not in the best condition. And then, I've applied for grants. One is Aldi, I haven't heard back from them. And then Sherwin-Williams for paint supplies. And then a big part of your Girl Scout Gold Award is working with your community. So I'm also looking. I worked with the Strongsville Education Foundation, and they have covered the full cost for the peace path, and they were gonna submit it to you for council. So I kind of just wanted to explain my project and share the project, and then that's kind of it. Sorry, I was nervous.
How old are you? You're amazing. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good job.
Thank you.
Thank you, Elle. I look forward to seeing what all you can accomplish at our elementary buildings. And if we can help in any way, just let us know.
Thank you so much.
All right, next on the agenda, I'm going to turn it over to Nick for the treasurer's report.
Thank you, Mrs. Housem. We have a couple items for your consideration this evening. Under item one, cafeteria price increase for breakfast, lunch, and a la carte. Be it resolved upon the recommendation of the treasurer that the cafeteria price increases for breakfast, lunch, and a la carte items be approved as listed in the exhibits. The price increases are as follows. Elementary and secondary breakfast will remain the same. Elementary and secondary lunch would increase by 15 cents each. Adult breakfast would increase by 25 cents. Adult lunch would increase by 85 cents, as well as various changes to the a la carte pricing. Okay. The next three items are the reestablishment of change funds throughout the district. Under item two, cafeteria change fund, be it resolved upon the recommendation of the treasurer that the cafeteria change fund be established in the amount of $1,000. These funds are used to establish startup funds for school cafeterias. Under item three, middle school athletic change fund, be it resolved upon the recommendation of the treasurer that the middle school change fund be established in the amount of $500. These funds are to be used to establish startup funds for middle school athletic events. And then number four, the high school derby change fund, be it resolved upon the recommendation of the treasurer that the high school derby change fund be established in the amount of $100. These funds are to be used to establish startup funds for the Derby Spirit Shop within the high school. And with that, that concludes the treasurer's report. Are there any questions?
No questions.
Okay.
Thanks, Nick. Next on the agenda, a superintendent's report. Be it resolved upon the recommendation of the superintendent that the revised academic calendar for the 2023-2024 school year be adopted as presented in the exhibit. And if you remember, as we discussed last meeting, this is moving a day off from March 8th to April 8th due to the solar eclipse that is taking place on April 8th. Does anyone have any questions? Okay, moving on to business services. Item one, be it resolved upon the recommendation of the superintendent that the Board of Education approves the annual membership renewal and safety program with Ohio School Council for a total amount of $2,759.42. Item two, be it resolved upon the recommendation of the superintendent that the schedule of rental fees for direct and indirect costs be approved as it appears in the exhibit. The rental rates are unchanged from previous years. This is an item we approve annually regardless of no changes. And item number three, under business services, be it resolved upon the recommendation of the superintendent that the following gifts be approved. Mrs. Marge Tablion made several donations totaling $1,100 in memory of Mike Tablion, grandfather of 12th grade student Lily Vassell. These donations are to be used for orchestra / symphony. Thank you for that. Next, I'm going to turn it over to Michelle to go through curriculum.
Okay. The first five items here under curriculum are all routine items. Every summer we approve new handbooks for the upcoming school year. So after our approval tonight, you'll be able to find them on the website shortly, and it is always a good idea to review them before your students go back to school. So item one, Strongsville Early Learning Preschool Student Handbook. Be it resolved upon the recommendation of the superintendent that the Strongsville Early Learning Preschool Student Handbook for the 23-24 school year be approved. Two is the Elementary School Student Handbook. Be it resolved upon the recommendation of the superintendent that the Strongsville Elementary School Handbook for the 23-24 school year be approved. Third is the Middle School Handbook. Be it resolved upon the recommendation of the superintendent that the Middle School Student Handbook for the 23-24 school year be approved. Item four, Strongsville High School Student Handbook. Be it resolved upon the recommendation of the superintendent that the Strongsville High School Student Handbook for the 23-24 school year be approved. And finally, this is the Athletic Handbook. Be it resolved upon the recommendation of the superintendent that the Strongsville High School Athletic Handbook for the 23-24 school year be approved. And finally, We have one student teacher placement. Be it resolved upon the recommendation of the superintendent that the following student teacher be placed. And this is Kristen Ostrich, and she will be assigned to Strongsville High School. Erica Powell from September 1st to December 2nd. She's a student at Baldwin Wallace College. And then I am going to move directly into the student services report on Andy's behalf tonight. Once again, these are largely routine items that we approve in the summer in preparation for the start of our school year. So this first item is PSI Affiliates, PSI Associates Incorporated. Be it resolved upon the recommendation of the superintendent that the Board of Education enters into an agreement with PSI Affiliates / PSI Associates in the amount of $8,987.58 for speech language pathologist services to service students at St. Joseph and John Interparochial School during the 23-24 school year. Second item, Education Alternative Service Agreement. Be it resolved upon the recommendation of the superintendent that the Strongsville Board of Education enters into a tuition excess cost agreement with Education Alternatives for placement of students with disabilities for the 23-24 school year. Third item, Educational Service Center of Northeast Ohio. Be it resolved upon the recommendation of the superintendent that the Board of Education enters into an agreement with the Educational Service Center of Northeast Ohio for admission of students for visual audiology and or hearing impaired services for the 23-24 school year. Two more of these long ones. Item number four, Educational Service Center of Northeast Ohio. Be it resolved upon the recommendation of the superintendent that the Strongsville Board of Education enters into an agreement with the Educational Service Center of Northeast Ohio for PBIS consultants for the 23-24 school year. And number five, United Cerebral Palsy Association of Greater Cleveland. Be it resolved upon the recommendation of the superintendent that the Strongsville Board of Education enters into an agreement with United Cerebral Palsy Association of Greater Cleveland for the special education and related services for placement of a student with disabilities in the amount of $85,050 for the nine-month program during the 23-24 school year and $9,450 for the fiscal year 24 extended school year. All of those contracts can be found in our agenda if you're interested in looking more specifically at what those are. Item number six is a settlement resolution, which also can be accessed in the agenda. And finally, item number seven.
Mrs. Bizzle.
Yes.
Item six requires an
individual
vote.
I missed that one. Thank you.
Thank you, Nick. Yep.
Do I have a motion?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
Motion by Ms. Stopchak, second by Mrs. Kilbane. Nick, can you take the roll?
Yes. Ms. Stopchak?
Yes.
Mrs. Kilbane?
Yes.
Mr. Micco?
Yes.
Mrs. Housem?
Yes.
And Mrs. Bissell?
Yes.
Okay. Motion carries.
All right. And the last item under student services is Education Alternative Student Transportation Agreement. Be it resolved upon the recommendation of the superintendent that the Strongsville Board of Education enters into a student transportation agreement with Education Alternatives. This agreement engages Education Alternatives to provide transportation services for the district students enrolled at Education Alternative school locations during the 23-24 school year. That concludes the student services report.
Thanks, Michelle. We will move into human resources. Letter I, item one, resignations of certified staff. Item two, retirements of non-certified staff. Item three, appointments of administration. Item four, appointments of certified staff. Item five, appointments of non-certified staff. Item six, appointments of non-certified athletic supplemental contracts. Item seven, appointments of certified staff supplemental contracts, additional time. Item eight, appointment of a kindergarten readiness assessment consultants. Item nine, appointments for summer learning 2023. Item 10, appointments for testing consultants. Item 11, additional time for non-certified staff. Item 12, more additional time for non-certified staff. Item 13, changes in hours for non-certified staff. Item 14, changes in status for non-certified staff. Item 15, a stipend for summer professional development. Item 16, a stipend for summer professional development. Number 17, a stipend for teacher-based team coaches. Item 18, volunteer coaches. Item 19, volunteers to volunteer within our schools. Item 20, athletic game worker pay rates. Be it resolved upon the recommendation of the superintendent that the amounts listed in the attached exhibit be paid to Strongsville City School personnel and non-personnel for performance as games workers for the 23-24 school year. Amounts to be paid through SCS payroll and accounts payable from the SHS Athletic Fund, SMS Athletic Fund, and the OHSAA Tournament Fund. Item 21, Security Services, Strongsville Police Department. Be it resolved upon the recommendation of the superintendent that the Board of Education authorizes the superintendent to work with the Strongsville City Police Department to provide security services to school buildings for the 23-24 school year. Officers to be paid at the rate of $35 per hour by timesheet as verified by the building administrator and the Strongsville City Police Department. Item 22, Works International, Inc. Be it resolved upon the recommendation of the superintendent that the Strongsville Board of Education approve Works International, Inc. to provide Employee Safe Program and Student Watch Program ongoing services for the 23-24 school year at a cost of $32,283. The next three items are corrections to previous agendas based on our recent approval of the SEA contract. Item 23, be it resolved upon the recommendation of the superintendent that the following correction be made. Correction to our May 25th, 2023 agenda. Mary Callow's position revised from marching band assistant director to high school assistant director of marching band. And Brandon Tyson's position revised from marching band assistant director to high school assistant director of bands, marching, and concert. Item 24, be it resolved by the superintendent that the following correction be made. Correction to agenda May 25th, 2023 under human resources. Appointments, non-certificated athletic supplemental contracts. Victoria Maloney's position be revised from flag instructor to high school color guard advisor. And last, item 25, correction to agenda, be it resolved upon the recommendation of the superintendent that the following correction be made. Correction to agenda May 25th, 2023, human resources, summer learning 2023. Sarah McKinley to be revised from intervention specialist to MI with RBT to be paid at step E. And that concludes the human resources report. Next on the agenda, superintendent's report technology. There's nothing to report there. Okay. Next on the agenda is our consent calendar. Action by the Board of Education and adoption of consent calendar at this point of the agenda means that all items appearing in this agenda denoted as type-action consent, which items constitute the consent calendar, are adopted by one single motion unless a member of the board or the superintendent requests that such items be removed from the consent calendar and voted upon separately. Do we have anything that needs removed? Hearing none, do I have a motion?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
Motion by Ms. Stavchuk, second by Mrs. Kilbane. Nick, can you take the roll?
Yes, 1 second. Ms. Stavchuk?
Yes.
Mrs. Kilbane?
Yes.
Mr. Miko?
Yes.
Mrs. Housem?
Yes.
And Mrs. Bissell?
Yes.
Motion passes. We do not have any superintendent timely information. Board of Education, other.
I just wanted to announce to the public that on Sunday, July 23rd at 12 p.m. at Strongsville Middle School, we will be having a dedication of George Grosan Way as a way to honor George's impact on our school district. All are invited, but we do... if you do want to attend, we ask that you RSVP to Dan Faust at either 440-572-7026 or dfaust@scsmustangs.org, just so we have an idea of how many people are attending. But I think it's going to be a great event and a nice ceremony.
Thanks, Rich. Next, we have meeting notifications. Before I read the two that are on the agenda, we do have our board retreat on July 27th scheduled, but I know there's going to be a scheduling conflict. So, Nick, if you could do us a notice to cancel that meeting, and we will get our calendars together to reschedule that. A regular Board of Education meeting work session will be held Thursday, August 3rd, 2023 at 7 p.m. in the meeting room of the Administration Building, 18199 Cook Avenue, Strongsville, Ohio. And a regular Board of Education meeting will be held Thursday, August 24th, 2023 at 7 p.m. in the meeting room of the Administration Building, 18199 Cook Avenue, Strongsville, Ohio. Next, we do have need for executive session to consider the employment of a public employee or official. Do I have a motion? Second?
Second.
Motion by Ms. Stavcek, second by Mrs. Kilbane. Nick, can you take the roll?
Ms. Stavcek?
Yes.
Ms. Kilbane?
Yes.
Mr. Miko?
Yes.
Mrs. Hausum?
Yes.
Mrs. Bissell, sorry.
Yes. We will enter into, motion passes. We'll enter into executive session at approximately 7:40, and we do not see a need to continue in public after we are done. So, want to wish everybody a great night.
Don't forget home days.